Today, it's market day in Oaxaca.
¿Qué va a llevar? ¿Qué le damos? Hay de pura carne. Hay de a 10, de a 5. ¿Qué va a llevar? ¿Qué le doy?
Jenny Rivera.
Va a ser carne, pues igual viene, si quieres guárdasela.
So chef, what do you think of this?
This?
Yes.
Well, this is, remember I told you about the criollo concept in food? So this is what we call criollo. Look at the color of the green, this is a green tomato. This is a purple, not a green tomato, but a purple tomato. So it's really nice and sweet. So I'm going to blanch it a little bit, and I'm going to see if I can find corn fungus to make like a salad, and I will serve fish on top of that. No, so I don't know. I'm just
thinking about it. Yeah.
Yeah, thinking about it. Look at this nice tomatoes as well. I'm using also this.
Me
puedes poner eso en una bolsita. Yes. ¿Qué más? Orégano, venden un poquito. Sí, como un mochicito.
5 pesos. You're pointing to some oregano as well.
Yes.
Great. Hay orégano, hay tomillo verde.
No, ahorita creo que orégano. Quiero también unos 5 elotes.
5 elotes,
sí, por favor. No. Cilantro no quiere Manuel. Yo no voy a ocupar cilantro. Yo llevo ya el orégano. Nada más. Con eso. La cuenta, pues.
Venta, 100.
¿Eso lo ponemos abajo?
150. 155.
Ay, pero deme para la chela. Y deme para mi agua.
So this is corn fungus. It's very useful in Mexican food. I would say this is the Mexican truffle, no? And we use it in many different ways, for soups, for rice. What we also do is like mix tamalizarlo, no? Cook with a limestone, and then just sauté, or I don't know, many, many different ways. Basically soups, for omelets, for breakfast, also good. And if you make a rice with lacoche, it's also an amazing thing. Very, very nice. There is an area in Etla that is very famous because of making this fresh cheese. No? You can just eat it like this or make a quesadilla and whatever.
The string cheese, what is it called in...
Quesillo.
The quesillo.
Quesillo. Yes. Look at all the stamps, no? This is bread. Hola, buenas tardes. Bread with a brown sugar. No, it's called mollete. Stuff that bread with the fresh cheese is delicious. That's one of the good things.
Martina sonríe porque
¿quién es Martina?
La que está contando.
Ah, no, está concentrada.
Debes hablarle a la gente.
Modélale. Aprovecha,
bueno, ¿cómo
están? Ya vi, qué rico. Aprovecho. So the smell, no?
Here.
This is what we call pan de yema. And it's yema, and yema means yolk. So it's made with lots of yolk, no? Lots of yolk, egg yolk. You dip it into the hot chocolate, and you eat it like this. Mm-hmm. Pan de yema. Buenas tardes. Look how beautiful it looks. This to cook. This is to mix chocolate, to prepare chocolate. Can be water or milk.
This is the big one.
Yes. All right, we're going to be making some hot chocolate and cappuccino. This. We yes, just bought this.
Very
tell,
good.
Tell me how I need to use this. And what is it?
It's to make hot chocolate.
It's called molenillo, and it's to make foam for the chocolate.
So
what,
so
what you do is you heat up water, which is a traditional way to have chocolate, or milk. And then once it's hot, then you add the chocolate. Grind it first, and then you go like this. Don't go deep, just on the surface, so it creates foam. And your chocolate should be foamy when you drink it. No? You can make your own cappuccino with this too.
So, I arrived to the market. I'm buying some hot chocolate, the best kind you can get, and we're gonna do it right now. Gracias. Bye bye. And off we go to make some hot chocolate. Chef, you seem to know your vendors.
Like, yes.
Here to your chicken. Is this where you usually get your chicken?
They're very good friends. No, no, I have delivery. But when I come here, I always buy from the same people around this, yes. I know they have good quality, they don't take advantage of me, and you know. After, gracias. Well, there's everything, as you can see, no? It's like, you want food, you want tools to cook, no? That is to use charcoal, also called anafres. And
anything you want.
Anything you want. Anything you want.
Do you ever use baskets in the
restaurant?
Yes, of course.
Yeah. It depends for what. When we have to store, I don't know, maybe bread or whatever. Mm-hmm. These things were used to put corn in there. No, I mean to crop corn. The corn with the husk, cut it from the corn plant, and then put it on your back, and you cut in the corn and put it into the piscador, they call it. Piscador, yes. This is what we are going to have for dinner tonight. So I'm going to cook fish with all these things.